segment of the show, we're calling To Scan or Not to Scan. And I have with me a panel of applications experts, Brian Godowskis, Jonathan Dove, and Dan Genlos. And we're going to talk about point-to-point inspection versus analog scanning and laser scanning. So let's start with that video that we just saw. We saw some kind of a blade laying on a table scan with a Romer arm. Is that, should we be scanning that part?
Well, it kind of depends a bit on the tolerances that you're looking for and actually the actual part or the application that you're looking. Sometimes on blades, they want to scan the root. Those tend to be very tight tolerances. And sometimes they want the contour or the shape of the airfoil itself. Those tend to be a little bit looser. And then you have the edges, the dangerous edges.
So the answer is tough. It depends.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, you brought some parts with you, so we can actually look at some things here in front of us. So why don't we start here what is that?
It's a nail gun. This is a Bosch nail gun, and basically it's got some interesting features. There's the original die-cast component, and then there's some machining that was done to the process later on. And that, as Brian was saying, it's not really the component, but the processes that we have to look at to decide whether we actually scan or not to scan.
Okay.
Or whether to use a laser scanner.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So scan or not scan this? What do you think?
I think a laser scan, the die-cast aluminum, would be a very advantageous. There's a lot of detail on this component, so a laser scanner would collect all of that information very rapidly.
Okay.
When you go into the internal components, you could actually either not scan, you could use touch probing on this component, depending on the tolerances. Now, if the tolerances got down really tight, it may be advantageous to scan them.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. And I would say I would add a little bit, this face right here might be a fit issue. So again, if you're looking at an operation that was making that or an issue in assembly, you might actually scan that as well for profile.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, let's look at the next one. What's the next thing here? Looks like some kind of a stamping.
Yeah, this is a safety belt holder.
Okay.
It's a sheet metal component, and so let's see what everybody say.
Yep.
So, what do you think, Dan?
A part like this stamping, I would probably be touch trigger probe. Probably wouldn't be scanning it. You could check the profile, the hole locations, but the tolerances aren't real tight. I don't think form is a big issue, so I wouldn't scan it.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with that. I think that's a good.
I would agree as well. It's a simple part, actually. Maybe a lot of features on it, but scanning doesn't gain you anything on this part.
No. So if someone came to you with that part and said, I want you to scan this, what would you say to them?
And tell them it's...
You're wasting your money spending it on a scanning machine.
Yeah. Totally agree.
All right. Well, let's move on to the next one. What do we got there?
So we've got here a medical component. It's a knee joint. So this is a really nice component.
Femoral.
You're going to most probably scan it because of the profile. The main feature is this complex profile, so you will most probably scan it.
Yeah.
Now, some of these femorals, they don't want to actually touch them, so there's other options in probing that we might propose.
But you'd be scanning with some kind of density. You're interested in that whole shape, right?
Yeah.
And let's be a little specific about it. We would probably not laser scan. Mm-hmm. We would touch scan or analog scan because we want the accuracy on that. Because typically in medical segments or medical sector, they tend to tightly tolerance their parts because of the effect of recalls would be a very bad thing.
There is one other sensor that we could use, the white light sensor, and that might actually give you some very good numbers. It's using chromatic white light, and it's extremely accurate, and it can work well on very shiny surfaces.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So, and the part on here is there's cross-sectional profiles, so at 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 40 degrees, they'll do cross-sections.
Okay.
And then they'll do linear ones this way.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
So a similar component is this.
And the mating component.
The mating component
actually
sort of works with it. So this
so
has
if
got,
you scan the one, would you scan the other?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
And the main thing is that there's a lot of profile call lights on this. So in the industry, if you look in industry currently, there's definitely a push to go away from straightforward dimensions and control things more with profile.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
And the datums on this part, the bottom face is your primary datum, and a lot of times I want to know the thickness. Well, if you have a form issue on this bottom face, getting the thickness could be a problem unless you're scanning.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
So this is quite an interesting component. It's a die-cast component, a little bit like this other one here. Mm-hmm. It has machine features. It has pretty generally toleranced holes, but then internally it has some fairly high accuracy features and bores in, where the control pistons go in here. So it's a top plate of a automatic transmission. This goes on there.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. What do you think, Brian? So, scan or not scan that?
This one definitely does not have one answer because of the different variety of features on the part. So if you were receiving, say, the part from a supplier of yours, you might, as the casting, do a laser scan on the casting surfaces of it. You would, on the flip side of it, completely different part now, you might analog scan the face here because there's likely to be a tight tolerance form call out on there.
And because it has to be a seal.
There has to be a seal between it and the transmission. And then the bores as well, you're going to analog scan those on the inside. But you do have some features that you would consider touch probing on just for speed, and that would be the threaded holes and maybe some of the outer holes on the outside.
Okay. So when you said touch probe and scan, so you're talking about a multi-sensor machine then.
You're definitely talking about a multi-sensor machine here. Yep.
What do you think, Dan? You look like you have something to say.
Yeah, multi-sensor machine, so you got the laser, CMS scanner, analog scanner for the face, and then touch trigger probe.
The nice thing about with the Hexagon product line, our scanning probes that would do the analog scanning on the top, we can also touch probe very rapidly. Mm-hmm. And that gives us the ability to do the mixed analog scanning and touch probing very, very accurately and very fast.
Mm-hmm. So, how about that black plastic one there? What's that?
So this component fits more likely into a vision machine.
Okay.
And vision machines can also scan.
Really? So, how does that work?
So it depends what type of sensors. There's multi-sensors that can go on them. You can use white light sensors, or you can use laser sensors, mm-hmm. or you can use camera. And a camera can actually, with the image, we can take high-density point gathering mm-hmm. on holes and other features.
Mm-hmm.
So this, if you were to choose a vision machine, most probably would scan it.
Okay. All right.
And this is a plastic part, automotive connector. A lot of times there's a profile call out because you have to have a tight seal so you don't mm-hmm. get water inside. So doing that outside profile of the camera is very useful.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Another thing that just to mention is one of the main things that you really need to do is to when you're choosing whether to scan or not to scan is to understand your processes.
Yes.
If you really understand your processes, that will actually decide what you're going to do. With this component here, there's the way it's manufactured, the material is slightly thicker here than here. So even though it's a seal, it could actually have shrinkage and sinkage, and you need to be looking for that. So mm-hmm. that's where scanning can be really, really useful.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, we're kind of running out of time, so I'm just going to give you each a minute to sort of give a summary. Dan, if company comes to you and says, I want to scan my parts, what do you say?
I got to look at a drawing, look at how many form callouts do you have, and what's your budget, and kind of determine whether scanning meets the requirement.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Jonathan, what do you?
I look at a couple of things. I look at their tolerances, and I also look at the depth of bores. One of the nice things about the scanning probes are their styli length is extended. Mm-hmm. So, for instance, we do have some of our customers, we use 400 millimeter styli that let us reach deep into a component. Mm-hmm. And even though we touch probe some of those components, we use a scanning probe because it gives you that helps accessibility. So I always look at it, to make an individual choice on the actual components they manufacture. So we like to provide the professional interpretation.
Okay. And Brian, bring us home.
I would say mainly that Hexagon has the ability with our probes, our scanning probes in particular, to touch probe very quickly. So we you really can't go wrong with a Hexagon product, being able to do both if you need to. But we still, in reviewing a customer's applications, look at each of the things that both Dan and Jonathan said in order to determine how the customer should approach each part. And in our training, we make sure that they know that.
The art of our belief of our company is to spend no more than they need to, but no less than they need
to.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. And no matter what you're trying to scan or how you're trying to inspect a part, it's important to hold it right.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
That's
well,
right.
And we've got something for you there, so take a look at this.
SwiftFix from Hexagon Metrology is a modular part holding system designed specifically with measurement in mind. SwiftFix aids part holding for inspection by many types of measuring equipment, such as portable measuring arms, stationary coordinate measuring machines, laser scanning devices, and optical and multi-sensor systems. The modular concept of the SwiftFix system means that fixtures of varying sizes and complexity can be constructed. And then, once the fixture is no longer needed, the parts can be stripped down and reused for another fixture. SwiftFix is based on a reusable lightweight aluminium plate, into which various types of holding and clamping components can be inserted to build up the required fixture. The multi-tapped base plates are supplied with a connection kit, which allows for multiple plates to be joined together in order to assemble fixtures for the holding of larger components. SwiftFix components are sold separately and in three predefined kits designed to match the complexity of the parts to be measured. The bronze kit includes 46 elements for the assembly of basic fixtures. The silver kit has 66 elements, and the gold kit contains 93, ideal for larger or more complex workpieces. SwiftFix allows for unlimited fixture configurations all from one kit. There's no need for expensive dedicated fixtures. No matter how complex the component to be measured, SwiftFix from Hexagon Metrology is flexible enough to offer the required solution. With just one kit, you have hundreds of fixtures. Just build, measure, strip down, and build again.